To succeed in e-commerce, you're gonna need three things. First, you're gonna need in-demand products to sell. You're also gonna need the skills to market those products. And then lastly, you're gonna need some drive and some grit to succeed. But finding popular products to sell can definitely be a challenge. So that's why we update this list every year to help you find some new trending products. Welcome back. I'm your host, Michelle Thalley. And if you're new, glad to have you. Thanks for tuning in. Learn with Shopify is a channel that is dedicated to helping small business owners with big plans. So if you want to learn how to start or grow your online business, make sure that you are hitting subscribe. Let's get into it. So here are the top trending products of 2021. And hopefully these are going to give you some new ideas for some new products for you. And I will also give you some tips on how to market each product that we do go through. All right, let's do it. If you're wondering where we're pulling this data from, these are products that were trending on Shopify between July to December 2020. So we definitely have some solid historical data to be backing these recommendations up. So let's start with doormats. Home decor has been huge during the pandemic. The more people are staying at home, the more inclined they are to be tweaking their space just to their liking. I know I myself did some renovations, but selling a simple item like a doormat is going to be scratching that home decor itch that people are having lately. So you can go the fancy or trendy route like this one over here, or you can go the more durable route like this doormat here. According to Keywords Everywhere, top doormat searches are doormats, funny doormats, indoor doormats, and outdoor doormats. To market this, you could run a pay-per-click campaign using Google Shopping ads, and then you could also use Facebook ads to attract new buyers. I would recommend you try bundling doormats with other home decor products that are also trending. Household storage containers. So similar to other trending products in the home goods department, we are probably seeing an increase in storage containers because everyone has just been working from home. So the storage containers that we're talking about are the ones that are helping people get organized, like stowing away your seasonal clothing or things that you're not using at the moment. The search term storage containers is generating 135,000 searches per month. That is a lot. And food storage containers is bringing in 74,000, so also a lot there. But basically, this is all supporting that storage containers can be a profitable business to start online right now. There are also many storage container types, so that's gonna give you a lot of different angles to choose from. So you can start by narrowing down what kind of containers you wanna sell. Is it fabric? Is it metal? And then once you've chosen your product, you're gonna wanna promote your product on popular organization and decor blogs. Another option is to partner or collaborate with interior designers, and that's really going to help promote your new product to their audience. Now, if a product recommendation is coming from a trusted source, like a blogger, like an interior decorator, then shoppers are definitely going to be more likely to buy. Kitchen towels. So kitchen towels saw huge growth in the last half of 2020. Now, this is not the most exciting product, but this trend does not look like it's slowing down. The kitchen towel market is expected to reach a value of $20 billion by 2026. That is a billion with a B. So this is not a trend that you're gonna wanna sleep on. Now, competition in this industry is definitely high. You have Williams-Sonoma and Bed Bath & Beyond, and they are taking up significant market share. But they all are targeting a very similar demographic. They are targeting older consumers with more disposable income. So if you wanted to target a different audience, there could be a potential gap that you can fill with your product. While cloth kitchen towels are the preferred product, research is also showing that people are leaning more towards hand knitted and crochet towels. So for this type of a product, you can try marketing this item on Amazon, and you can also use Google Shopping because people aren't really loyal when it comes to a product like this. This is usually just like an impulse buy, something that needs to get the job done. So you can also use a Facebook ads to help promote your product. Bike saddles. Okay, so remember summer 2020 when bikes were just completely out of stock everywhere? Well, it's clear that bikes are showing no signs of slowing down right now. Dad joke there for you guys. And bike saddles are next on our list. Bike saddles play a major role. They can be the difference between a very comfortable trip or a miserable one. Now, the perfect bike seat is gonna differ from person to person. depending on their riding style and depending on their preferences. So helping people find the best saddle can be a lucrative product for an online cycling store. Search volume for the term bike saddles is getting 22,200 searches per month. And then people are also looking for more specific types like comfortable bike saddles and road bike saddles. Now, this to me indicates that you can hold many variations and start making sales that way. Okay, so to market this product, why don't you try angling your store as the most comfortable gear on the market? So you can create videos to show how your bike seats are solving problems around comfort. Electronic accessories. Okay, so electronic accessories are one of those trending items that are consistently having high profit margins. This trend is definitely hotter at different times of the years than others, but other than that, it's pretty consistent throughout. The market is also massive and it is projected to reach $284 billion by 2026. Search volume for the term mobile accessories gets around 49,500 searches per month, and that is according to Keywords Everywhere. Now, you also have a ton of opportunity to target shoppers by device type, like Samsung or iPhone. All right, so just to give you some ideas, here are some things that you could sell for this category. You can try selling batteries, you can sell headphones, you could sell portable Bluetooth speakers or chargers, and then you can also try selling screen guards and cases. So hopefully that gave you some ideas. Now, try promoting via Google Ads. Google Ads is going to help you reach customers who have a very high intent to buy. Another option is using Facebook Ads, and that's going to help you target a very specific audience, maybe like campers who need durable phone cases. If you're looking to get started building your online business, but maybe you're not sure what to sell, or maybe you need help finding a product, then definitely make sure that you are checking out our free 40-minute webinar. That is going to teach you how to find winning product ideas, how to validate those ideas, and how to get started. So just click the link in the description box to get started with a free training. I will leave that for you guys. Toy kitchens and play food. Toy kitchens have been a very popular pastime for kids since the 20s, and they're even great for entertainment while parents are working from home. Now, today, companies are reimagining the toy kitchen. They are including non-binary, super cool setups, and then they also have Alexa-powered kitchens that have imaginary cooking tutorials. With 90,500 average monthly searches, it is pretty clear that toy kitchens are going to be powering through 2021. So when it comes to promoting toy kitchens, think of the concept friends trust friends. Marketing toys is really gonna rely on the recommendation from influencers and friends, so you're definitely gonna wanna collaborate with nano influencers on social media. So create content with kids that are using your toys, looking like they're having a blast. And another tip is if you do have the budget, try running a contest to give away some free toys. That's gonna help you grow your email list as well. And then you can use that email list to create drip marketing campaigns, and that's going to convert these subscribers into loyal customers over time. Motor vehicle, carpet, and upholstery. Over the past few months, we've seen car mats and upholstery sales drastically increase on the Shopify platform. There are 74,000 monthly searches for car mats on Google, and that really proves the industry's popularity. Newer search interest is popping up for WeatherTech floor mats, and that has 135,000 searches per month, as well as custom car mats. When marketing these, you really want to understand your target audience. So, for example, if your customer is very outdoorsy, they're going to want a durable rubber mat. But if they're big sports fans, they might want a branded mat. So really understanding your demographic is going to be key to marketing these products. You can promote these products in a number of ways. You can create installation videos, you can start a car blog, or you can even cross-promote with another automotive company. And then for this, you're definitely going to want to explore Facebook ads, and that is going to send traffic to your website and drive sales consistently throughout the year. This vertical also has a great opportunity to expand your product offering. Pretty much at any point, you can find new items to sell with product sourcing apps like Oberlo or Alibaba. Bookcases and standing shelves. There's been a growing trend in sales for bookcases and standing shelves in recent months, and that is definitely because people are just spending more time at home and they're looking to improve their space. The term bookcases generates over 300,000 searches per month, And you could also try Floating Shelves that has over 550,000 searches per month. So to market these, you can create a blog with interior design tips and have those blog posts link back to your products. Then you can also try running retargeting ads using Facebook or Google from that blog traffic. Bookends. All right, so keeping up with our book theme here, the next trending product on this list is bookends. So bookends are those like pretty heavy items that you position on either end of your row of books, and it keeps your books in an upright position. They are a really nice way for customers to spice up their home libraries and just like make their space a little more cute and homey. So there's no shortage of the types that you can sell. You can sell mythical creatures, you can sell large crystals, abstract designs. Those are just some off the top of my head, but they're also gonna come in a ton of different materials. So if you prefer stone or metal or wood, and the nice thing about this product is you can get really creative. There is no limit to this. So like I said, from the seller standpoint, this leaves you with no lack of options for coming up with new designs. There is tons of room to be creative. There's definitely enough customers out there that are looking to buy. The phrase bookends is receiving 135,000 monthly searches, and decorative bookends and vintage bookends are also receiving some love as well. If you run a home decor shop, there's a lot of ways that you can market this product. So first off, you can share some how it's made content. I think customers love that kind of like behind the scenes footage, and then you can post that on social media. Also, if you are on Instagram, make sure that you're using your hashtags, and also make sure that you're using stickers on your content so that people can buy easily. Another focus is Google search. So like I said, there is a lot of search volume for this term, so this might be your best bet in selling these products online. And you can use ads to target high intent shoppers and drive them to your website to make a purchase. All right, so next up we have temporary tattoos. With the pandemic closing tattoo shops, people are starting to turn to realistic looking temporary tattoos as a way of expressing themselves. And it's really the younger generation that is driving this cultural change. They're popular amongst creatives, musicians, and artists, and they're marketed as a way to be creative without having the lifelong commitment. Now, if you want to turn your temporary tattoo into a bestseller, you are definitely going to want to market this on social media. You could use Pinterest to create inspiration boards for people that are looking to get inspired before, you know, making a purchase. I know a lot of people are using Pinterest to start getting some ideas. And then other than that, you're definitely going to want to use TikTok. So on TikTok, you can show the process of maybe like creating a sleeve, or maybe you can show the process of how like the tattoo develops over time. Like the options are really endless here. And then on the Instagram side, you're definitely going to want to focus on publishing carousel posts. That's going to work well for two reasons. First, you can show off all the different designs that you have in your store with a carousel, which is great. And then secondly, carousel posts receive up to 5% higher engagement as it compares to regular posts. Needlecraft patterns. Needlecraft patterns are another one of the most popular products to sell in 2021. Needlecraft includes embroidery, needlepoint, and knitting. So those are all spaces that you can play in. And people really tend to like this because it helps reduce stress, it helps keep your mind active, and it's a nice creative outlet. Now, the term needlecraft patterns doesn't get that much search volume. It sits at around 70 per month. However, embroidery patterns, that one receives 49,500 monthly searches. So in this space, if you're looking to play here, you could sell needlecraft tools for different techniques, like cross stitch, for example. To promote these products, become an active member of forums and Facebook groups. And then once you're in these groups, you're gonna wanna share your skills and insights. Building community, especially in niche markets like these, are gonna help you reach your target audience faster and easier. You can sell a needlecraft pattern as a PDF download, and then you can send these guides along with tutorials for your customers. If you wanna run Facebook ads, consider targeting your audiences by interest. So that might include arts and crafts, embroidery, or needlepoint. Also, use Facebook Audience Insights. That's an amazing tool to find different countries where needlepoint might be popular, like the US and the UK. Hairstyling tools and accessories. If you're looking to get into the beauty industry, hairstyling accessories are seeing an increase across Shopify, Overlo, Google, and AliExpress. So pretty much everywhere. Now, according to data from Keywords Everywhere, The term hairstyling tools receives 12,100 searches per month. Subcategories like hot tools is getting 33,100 every month, which is great. And then keywords everywhere is also showing that the top 20 YouTube videos for hairstyling are receiving an average of 1.7 million views per month. That's a lot. So these topics are ranging anywhere from hairstyling tutorials to reviews and tips. So hopefully you're seeing a trend here. There is definitely a market for hairstyling tools. When you're selling trending items in the health and beauty space, you're definitely going to want to use a more visual platform. So you're going to want to try Instagram and YouTube. You could also partner up with influencers in this space, maybe run some Instagram ads just to hype up the products, make a couple of sales quickly. But marketing hair accessories has a ton of opportunities. You could do a Q&A on Instagram Live on maybe like how to use the tools, how to get a desired look, or you can create some funny reels to promote your products. But you're definitely going to want to partner with influencers on YouTube. There is a huge beauty community there, and that's going to really help drive some sales. So there you have it. Those have been the top trending products to sell in 2021. Now, the thing is, finding the right product is only half the equation. The other half is learning how to market them. So if you are looking to stay up to date with your marketing education, make sure that you are hitting subscribe, because this channel has all the content that you need to learn how to market your business and be a successful online entrepreneur. If you're interested in hands-on training that's going to walk you through the process of building a website around a profitable niche and finding the right products, then you're going to want to watch our free dropshipping business webinar series. One e-commerce entrepreneur is going to share how they grew one of their online business ideas to over 8,000 unit sales per year, along with the marketing tactics that worked and the ones that flopped. So if you're interested in that, make sure that you're checking out the link in the description box. Once you've chosen your product, the next step is to create your online store and start making sales. Shopify has everything you need for that. So you can set up your store in a matter of days and bring your brand to life. You can get started with a free 14-day trial. I will make sure to leave a link in the description box for you guys to get started on your business journey. If you thought this video was helpful, make sure that you are giving it a big thumbs up. That actually helps our community and our channel grow. Also, make sure that if you have any questions about anything that I talked about today, leave them in the comment section. I will do my best to get back to you guys. Other than that, don't forget to subscribe. That way you're not going to be missing out on any more future videos on how to start or grow your online business. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next one. Bye.